In OAuth 2 or OpenID Connect, there's often talk of two different types of tokens, an access token and a refresh token. An access token is your standard token, which you get in exchange for an access token request, typically requiring that the user authenticates, and in return, a web service will get an access token. That access token is then used as the way to access various APIs, either at the authorization server or at various backends, or even at third parties. And that access token typically has a limited lifetime. It has a validity time from the time of issue to the time of expiry, and you can use it while it is still valid. The access token expires at that time, but it can also be revoked earlier. So there's typically a revocation process where the access token can be revoked, which is typical in the event of a logout event or some other information change or system change where issued access tokens can be revoked. The authorization server offers an endpoint where that access token can always be checked. Is it still valid? And endpoints for finding out more information about the user, typically called the user information endpoint or the token introspection endpoint. The other token which comes up is called the refresh token. And the refresh token is all about having a way that the user doesn't have to interactively always offer a way that always doesn't have to sign in. Instead, they can sign in once and issue a refresh token to a web service, which allows that web service to request access tokens on behalf of the user without the user being present. So the way it works is that you ask the user, please to sign into the application, and you request along with that a refresh token. That refresh token is then saved in the user account of the application for next time when the application needs to access an API on behalf of the user. So it may be a batch call in the middle of the night when the user is no longer on the website, or it might be a time when the user opens an app on their mobile phone the next day and wants to access API data without having to sign in again interactively. So in this flow, you exchange the refresh token for an access token, and it's a request done by the connecting application where they send the refresh token and request in response a fresh access token. And then all of the flows are similar, that they use the same access token. Together with that refresh token request, typically a new refresh token is issued so that the next request will use a new refresh token.